Hello friends, my name is Nick Klemetson, organist and director of music here at St. Paul's Lutheran Church and School. This Monday, I wanted to do a little bit something different. You've heard this organ played regularly on Music Mondays, but today I kind of wanted to take you on a little tour of it and show you how it works and tell you what it's all about. So we'll start with the most general information. This organ was built in 1976 by the W. Zimmer and Sons Organ Company. They are centered in North Carolina, and the company is still in existence, though under a different name. When most new organs are constructed, they are done with the help of a consultant, who is typically the person who's on site, who has the most say in the specifications of the organ, etc. The consultant for this instrument was Paul Bungus, who is a church musician and professor of music at Concordia College. He's well known in this area, or was well known in this area. He designed over 100 organs in Minnesota and in Iowa. Organs are divided into what are called divisions. This organ has four divisions. The three keyboards from top to bottom are called the choir, the grate, and the pedal. the grate and the positive. There are reasons for these names, but I'll skip these types of explanations about why things are named the way they are. Otherwise, this video would be too long. The fourth division is the pedal division, and it's down below. The keyboards each have 64 notes, and the pedal has 32 foot pedals, which is typical for most organs designed today. Each division of the organ consists of what are called ranks. Each rank is a set of pipes that correspond to a certain sound on the organ that are controlled by these draw knobs. The manual ranks, or the ranks for the keyboards, each have 64 pipes, which correspond to the 64 keys, and likewise, the pedal ranks have 32 pipes. Most of these draw knobs control just one rank of pipes, but there are several that control multiple ranks at once, and we'll talk more about that later. St. Paul's organ has 39 ranks in total, and we'll start going through those now. Starting on the grate division, we have the rank that really provides the basis of what a pipe organ, or why a pipe organ sounds the way it does. This is the 8-foot principle. The reason this is referred to as an 8-foot pipe is kind of complicated, but the most basic way of explaining it is that the length of the pipe of the lowest note of an 8-foot rank is approximately 8 feet long. So the pipe that plays this note is approximately 8 feet long. This has to do with the speed of sound and other acoustic factors, but generically that's kind of what it means. More simply, the 8-foot ranks of pipes are your neutral sounding pitches. That is, they would match the frequencies played in the same octave as a piano. So this note on an 8-foot rank on the organ would sound the same as that note played in that octave on a piano. This is A440. So the 8-foot principle is sort of the body of the organ. It's the fundamental sound that you build around. Above that, you have a 4-foot principle, which sounds exactly an octave above the 8-foot rank. Here's the 4-foot by itself. And then both together. Above that, we have a 2-foot stop, which by itself sounds like this. And it can be, of course, combined with the 8-foot and 4-foot ranks. Here's all three of them. This 8-foot, 4-foot, 2-foot combination is called the principal chorus. And it really makes up the basis for accompanying congregational song. We'll talk more about this combination of 8-foot, 4-foot, and 2-foot pipes later, but first let's finish going through the rest of the grate. I mentioned the 2 foot already. It's not, unlike the 8 foot and the 4 foot, this stop is not a principal stop, but rather it's a flute stop. And now it's time to mention that organ stops belong to different families, kind of. On this organ, we have principals, flutes, reeds, mixtures, and finally mutations. I'll talk about what each of those are as we come to get to them. Another thing I don't really have time to talk about is that different pipes are made of different materials and things like that, which is how they make different sounds, but that's a whole nother Music Monday. But continuing on with the great, we have our first mixture. The mixture on the great is our first example of having a draw knob that has more than one rank on a stop or on a draw knob. This mixture has four ranks, as indicated by the Roman numeral 4 that's written on the draw knob. Well, a single rank only sounds one pitch. Four ranks at once obviously sounds four pitches. With mixtures, you don't really perceive them as four different pitches, but rather, because of confusing reasons involving acoustics and physics and the overtone series, the four pitches kind of coalesce and bring a brightness and a brilliance to the sound. So the mixture by itself. You can hear a kind of overlap there. So yeah, there are four pitches sounding in there, but they all kind of blend together. Here's the principal chorus, again, without the mixture. And now with the mixture. So like I said, mixtures kind of add a brilliance to the sound, and the principal chorus plus mixture creates an organ concept called the plenum, which is a kind of a fancy organ word for loud, or more appropriately, I would say strong. Now that we've established the kind of the basis for the great division, I'm going to demonstrate it on the other two manuals. Let's look at the positif first, which are these stops here. This is the lower manual, and the ranks for these pipes are found behind me in the box that kind of looks over the top of the sanctuary. The 8 foot stop on this organ is a very gentle flute stop. It's actually the quietest stop on the organ. But despite its lack of volume, it still provides kind of the foundational sound for the positif division. The positif has a 4 foot principal, which by itself sounds like this. And combined with the 8 foot. Excuse me. And then we have a 2 foot flute stop, which on top of those two creates the principal chorus for the positif division, and that sounds like this all together. We also have a mixture available on the positif, but instead of being four ranks like it is on the great, it's only three, hence the Roman numeral 3. And this is what that all sounds like together. So the great and the positif are both capable of their own plenums. And it just so happens that the choir division, which is the top manual, is also capable of that same thing, and we'll go through that now. So first of all, for the choir division, these ranks are contained right in front of the organ. And these shutters that you can see there are controlled by the foot pedal that's below me. When a division has one of these, it's referred to as enclosed, meaning it's capable of creating dynamics. The 8 foot stop on the choir is probably the only hybrid stop on the organ. It's called a Gemshorn, which is kind of a flute string hybrid. It sounds like this. Then it's combined with the 4-foot flute, which also happens to be the only 4-foot flute on this organ. And there's a 2-foot principal on top of that. And to make the planum, we actually have 2 different options for mixtures. The first is a 2-rank mixture that actually has a very specific set of 2 pitches to go along with it. Combined with the principal chorus, it sounds like this. And there's also a 3-rank mixture called a scharf, which I think blends with the principal chorus a lot better. It's very bright and very brilliant though, so I use it with caution. So there you have it. Each organ manual or division is capable of a planum sound. And technically the pedal has its own planum too, but instead of 8-foot, 4-foot, 2-foot, it uses 16-foot, 8-foot, 4-foot. The 16-foot stop is kind of hard to hear by itself, but it's kind of more felt than heard, but this is what it sounds like on its own. Then we add on the 8-foot above it. Then the 4-foot. And finally the 3-rank mixture on the pedal to complete the planum. So, principals and choruses, or principal choruses and mixtures for the whole organ are now covered. Before we get into another category of pipes, I want to briefly mention the only 16-foot rank on the manuals, which is here on the grate. The 16-foot flute on the grate is something that adds some heft and some body to the standard principal chorus. Here's the principal chorus again without the 16. With the 16. I almost never use that 16-foot stop when I'm playing hymns, but I use it a lot with certain types of repertoire. I actually used it on Music Monday last year to kind of create that muddy, ominous sound for Jesus Christ is Risen Today, which sounded like this. So that really low 16-foot rumbling sound down there worked great. Next, let's talk about a new category of stops, and those are the reeds. This organ has 4 reeds that are all different and all very unique. The first is also the largest, which is the trumpet. This is the biggest reed on the organ, but it's also not so big that it can't be used in combination with other stops. This is the organ, trumpet on the grate by itself. The reed on the choir is called the chalumet, and it's kind of a hybrid reed. It's too quiet to be a trumpet, but it's too big to be an oboe. It sounds like this. The reed on the positif is called a crumb horn, which kind of sounds like a buzzy clarinet. It's actually one of the oldest types of organ pipes as well. It sounds like this. The final reed is on the pedal, and it's kind of a 16-foot version of the great trumpet, only it's its own rank, it's its own pipes. It's called a bombard. It's what gives the bass or of the organ its growl. This is by itself. It doesn't sound very good by itself, but it's also much louder up here than it is down in the sanctuary. But it's a very usable, lovely reed that adds a lot of grandeur to the plenum. That pretty much does it for the reeds on the organ. Last up are the mutations. There aren't many on this organ. Basically, a mutation is a rank that sounds a certain interval higher than the pitch that you're playing. The two mutations I have on the positive here are the 2 2/3 mutation and then the 1 3/5. What those fractions mean are the 2 2/3 sounds a 12th higher than a standard 8-foot pitch. I'll demonstrate that. Here's middle C at 8-foot. And here's middle C at 2 2/3, it'll sound a 12th higher. Okay, so it's an octave and a fifth. So the equivalent note on the great would be this. Okay, we also have the 1 3/5 mutation, which sounds 2 octaves and a major third above. So that equivalent note would be way up here. And those are two different pitches right now, but that's okay. These two mutations on the positive combine with the 8-foot, 4-foot, and 2-foot stops on the positive to create something very special on this organ called a cornet, which is a very specific combination of those five ranks. It's a standard organ solo line combination that can be used in a great variety of repertoire. Here's what the cornet sounds like by itself. And you can kind of combine it together, you know, just to play a solo line, maybe of a hymn. If you've listened to organ music, I'm sure you've heard that sound before, but now you know what it actually means and what it's called. On this organ, these five ranks that comprise the cornet are all on separate draw knobs, but on many organs, particularly ones that are kind of designed in the French Romantic style of organ, like the one Vidor would have played, for example, that I showed last week, there would be a single draw knob that would activate all five ranks. The Dobson pipe organ that's at Wartburg, in the Wartburg Chapel, has one of those, for example. But here they are all separate. The only other mutation on this organ is in the pedal division, and it's a 5 1/3 mutation. I almost never use this one by itself. I think it sounds a fifth above. Let's see. So never mind. Let me do that again. I'll talk about couplers later, but this is the 8-foot principal on the great, and this is the mutation by itself. So it sounds a fifth above. Or technically it's a fifth above this note. You see how those match up. What's next? Oh, I almost never use that mutation on the pedal, but it's interesting because you can actually use it when you're playing a melody on the pedals, using the 8-foot, the 4-foot, the 5 1/3 mutation, and the 2-rank mixture, it creates kind of a 5-rank fake cornet down in the pedal division. So you can kind of solo out a melody in the pedal at one point if you want to, using a combination of those 5 ranks. That covers it, I think, for every rank on the organ, except for one. That's called a celeste. It's here on the choir. A celeste is what creates that shimmer. It's a pipe that's slightly out of tune, and it enables that shimmery sound that's usually combined with the 8-foot Gemshorn on the choir. Here's the Gemshorn by itself. And here's with the celeste. So it creates that shimmer there. So that covers it for all of St. Paul's organ's 39 ranks. Next to talk about are these rocker tabs here that are here in the center of the organ. These are called couplers, and they enable me to tie together certain manuals so that I can play more than one division at a time. I'm able to couple both the choir and the positif to the great. I can also couple the choir to the positif by itself, and I can couple all of the manual divisions down to the pedal. So let's say I wanted to combine the 8-foot principal on the great with the crumb horn, the reed on the positif. All I would have to do is pull both of those draw knobs, as I just did, and activate the positif to great coupler, and I can play both of those on the great. So couplers are very useful when wanting to combine certain sounds together. The last thing I'll show you today is called the combination action. This is like the transmission of the organ. It enables me to create preset registrations or collections of all of these draw knobs and save them so that I can press a button and have that saved preset come up on the organ. Here on the left side of the keyboards, there are 8 buttons, and these are called pistons. These eight control the entire organ. I have these 8 specifically set up for hymn playing. The first 4 go from quietest to loudest here, and the rest of them have certain combinations that allow me to vary things depending on the stanza of the hymn. So here's from gentlest to strongest in playing Tallis' Canon. So there are 8 general pistons, and then also 8 toe studs, which function exactly the same. So if my hands are busy and I can't press a piston with my thumb or with a finger, I can use my foot to press the toe stud, like this. I can do the same thing just with my feet instead of my hands. There are also 5 pistons that function for each of the manual divisions. So these 5 pistons only operate the stops on the great, these 5 only operate the stops on the choir, etc. And there are also 5 toe studs specifically for the pedal division. So just these stops here. So I think that covers everything this organ is capable of. I hope you enjoyed this tour of St. Paul's organ. I hope you learned something. And if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact me or leave a comment on social media or send me an email, and I will get back to you. Thanks so much, and I will see you next time on Music on Mondays.